Building a Stuart 504 boiler plant, part 6. Painting the tank base, making the tank lid, and veneering the baseboard. If you watched the previous episode, you will realise that this part has just come out of the dishwasher and it really is very clean. And I'm about to paint it, but I don't want to paint the threads of the unions, so I'm just putting some silicone rubber over these. It's quicker and easier than masking tape. In the outer part of my workshop, it is currently about 2 degrees below zero, and I know that's nothing if you live in Siberia, or maybe Alaska, but it's cold enough for me, and I'm keeping my tin of etch primer in the warmer part of the workshop. I've shaken it up, and now it's time to spray the part with it. And I'm spraying this on a piece of wood on top of my belt sander in the outer part of the workshop, where it's quite cold. This stuff really does spray horribly. It splats all over the work. I don't quite get it, but somehow it goes smooth before it dries. And it does the trick. It sticks very well to the metal. And I don't think that it's anything to do with temperature. It's just the way this paint is. Maybe the nozzle is a bit suspect. But having said that, I've sprayed quite a lot of this stuff onto pieces of metal in recent months. And the spraying process was very similar from each can. And now that the part is painted, I'm taking it back into the warmer part of the workshop. But now, already, it's the next day. I don't remember going to bed. And as it says on the tin, to wait 24 hours before recoating, I've waited 24 hours. I'm spraying the tank base now using some satin black. And this stuff sprays really well. I find this to be very good quality paint. And I've got this down to a fine art. I can put just enough paint on to do it in one go, without the paint running, and without it being too thick and going orange peely. But I think that's sometimes down to the quality of the paint, and as I said earlier, this is really good stuff. I don't want to give this another coat, so very carefully, after I've painted the outside, I'm painting the inside. And that's it, there's sufficient paint on the thing now. I don't need to go mad, because it would be really tragic if I put too much paint on and it ran down the side, but it's not going to do that. As I expected, I got a comment when I put this part in the dishwasher, saying that the lead solder will contaminate the dishwasher and it will be the end of civilization as we know it, and probably the start of a zombie apocalypse. But when I see people walking around looking at their mobile phones all the time, I think the zombie apocalypse has already started. Although I really only got one health and safety type comment, the rest of the comments were from viewers saying that their wives wouldn't allow things like that in the dishwasher. Well, I don't have that problem. I've had two wives, and I haven't currently got one, and I don't want any more of those. This, by the way, is the water pump mounting block. That's going to be painted very shortly, but I think you've seen enough painting for the time being. So now, by way of a change, I think I will plank the baseboard with some mahogany strip. I'm really running low on this stuff. I used to buy quite a lot of this mahogany strip from a local model shop, but the model shop closed, and since I've bought some from the internet. And that's fine, but it's much more expensive than it used to be from the model shop. When I think about it, that's probably why the model shop ceased trading. Anyway, what I'm doing at the moment is sorting out the mahogany strips so that they look good together. Sometimes different colours and textures don't look good next to each other, so I'm sorting them out first before I stick them down. I'll be sticking them down later on in the video. A few minutes ago you saw me painting the lower part of the tank. And thanks to the magic of video, 24 hours has now elapsed, and I can now assemble the entire thing. I've made a couple of gaskets, this is one of them for the bottom part of the tank, and to fix the support column in place, I'm using an M6 countersunk bolt. And here's the column, firmly fixed in place. As this is a water tank, and even though I fitted it with a gasket, I still needed to use a stainless steel bolt to prevent it going rusty. And the easiest way to find a stainless steel bolt is to use one of these. This is a telescopic magnet. It doesn't need to be telescopic, any magnet will do. I just have one of these in the workshop in case I drop some pieces of metal in inaccessible places. And as you can see, the magnet has no difficulty in attracting the bolt and the Allen key. But what's going on here? This bolt is not magnetic, yet it's steel. Is this witchcraft, I ask myself? It's a kind of metallurgical witchcraft that I know nothing about. Not all stainless steel is non-magnetic, some stainless steel is magnetic, but this M6 Allen cap head bolt and this washer and the nut that I'm not going to be using is non-magnetic, and therefore it's stainless steel and perfect for holding the water tank components together. And here's another top tip, that's two tips in one episode. I'm using a pair of surgical forceps to initially hold the Allen key, and once the Allen key is in position in the Allen head bolt, I use my Barco spanner to tighten the Allen key. And that's it, the tank is assembled. In this clip, I'm holding the tank upside down and I'm drawing round it on a piece of brass, because this piece of brass is going to be machined to make the top cap. The purpose of this top cap, apart from it's going to look good, is to keep the inside of the water tank clean when the boiler plant's not in use, because when the boiler plant's in use, generally speaking, the top cap will not be in position, because I'll need to top up the tank very frequently. I roughly cut out the shape on the bandsaw, and now I'm finding the centre of this piece, because I need to drill a hole in the middle, which I'm going to thread 2BA. I'm going to fit a 2BA bolt, and this will be clamped in the chuck, so then I'll be able to turn this very rough brass blank into a very nice top cap for the water tank. Now I've found the centre, I'm using a centre punch to punch the hole. There it goes. Then I took it over to the drilling machine and drilled the hole in the centre, which is 5/32 of an inch in diameter, and in this clip I'm threading the hole using a 2BA tap, after which I screw in a 2BA bolt, followed by a 2BA nut, and as you can see the whole thing's quite off centre because it was only a rough cut to start with. But I did allow for this by cutting on the outside of the felt tip pen line, so by the time I've got it to the right size it will be a perfect fit on the top of the water tank. This clip on screen at the moment is running much faster than it should be, and that's why the brass blank looks more wobbly than it actually was. Either way though, it's not important, this is only a top cap for a water tank. I still need the part of the top cap that's going to fit in the top of the tank to be accurate, so I'm taking my time with this and getting it dead right. You may notice that I've changed the tool to a parting tool because this cuts a much squarer edge. But if you're doing a job like this, bear in mind this is only held by the nut of a 2BA bolt, so you can't put a lot of pressure on it, and be more gentle than it looks with this. Once I cleaned up the outer edges, I removed the nut and used some fine sandpaper, followed by some Scotch-Brite, to get a finish like this. I need to make an ornamental knob to fit on the top of it. And this is a simple plain turning job, but I've really speeded this up because it takes a while to do really. The hole in the centre is 2BA, which will fit on a 2BA bolt that will go through the cap. Once I parted off the component, I refitted it to a 2BA bolt held in the chuck, and by applications of different grades of sandpaper followed by polishing it on the polishing spindle, the finished part looks exactly like this. And now to complete the job, I just need to verify that this is a stainless steel bolt. Well, it's not magnetic, so I guess it is. All that's left to do now is to fit the 2BA bolt to the threaded top cap from underneath, and then fit the small knob to the top of the 2BA bolt. And that's it. When I first started this very simple ornamental turning, I didn't really know what the knob was going to look like. If I was going to make more than one, I would use a form tool. But this is an absolute one-off, and there's only one like it in the world, and here it is. I'm quite pleased with the way this water tank's turned out. It looks exactly like I thought it would look when I started making it. Time now to work on the baseboard. Now this can be a very tedious job, so after a while I really am going to speed this one up. What I'm doing at the moment, to illustrate a point, is spreading on lots of adhesive. This adhesive is the stuff I usually use, and it's called cyanoacrylate adhesive, or CA glue, or super glue. This is the high viscosity version. But I never did find it successful spreading a lot of adhesive on and then sticking several planks on. I generally do them one at a time. That way I make sure every plank is firmly stuck down. When I'm cladding a boiler in mahogany strip though, I do put plenty on, and I put several pieces of wood on at one go. But fitting cladding to a copper boiler is very different to this job. The cyanoacrylate adhesive will generally stick the mahogany to the copper, but not very well and not very permanently. The brass boiler bands normally hold the wood in position. But in this application, it's very important that every one of these mahogany planks is firmly stuck to the plywood base. So you can see the principle, plenty of CA glue and stick the planks down. And it doesn't matter at all if you get this stuff on top of the planks, because by the time you sand them down, it all disappears and doesn't leave any marks whatsoever. And finally, with every plank stuck to the plywood, that's it for now. Thanks for watching, and I hope you found it useful.